When we started our journey, earlier there was no partner ecosystem as such, so everyone knows about that. And we were planning, or rather we were looking for how to get entered or aligned with the Frappe or ERP. That is what our goal was initially, but somehow we were not getting aligned. And we were quite struggling. Most of the conference, there was some kind of fighting or mini fights. It happened multiple times. Huh? MRP next, yeah, that was one of yeah, that was one story. So earlier, I think we are working with Frappe and ERP Next for a long time. This is more than a decade now. Before partner ecosystem came into a picture, before that there was one foundation, ERP Next Foundation. We were one of the part of that foundation. We were listed on website, but it was not a partner ecosystem. And most of the time the discussion was revolving around that there has to be some partner network. Whereas I think Rushabh was not keen for that arrangement. He was not, because that was the immature stage might be, yes. And the importance came into existence after close to the lockdown phase or before lockdown phase. That time the things started falling into place. So earlier we were acting as a general service provider, major focus on the customization side, technology side, not on the implementation side. Then the partner program came into picture. So we thought, let's try to become a branch partner and see how we can get aligned with their thought process and whether it really makes sense from a business point of view. Because we being into a private industry, business matters a lot. Yes, we are banging on some open source product, but that is how we are earning. So we became a branch partner. Then branch partner gives us some confidence. There is a something falling in place in terms of partner ecosystem. And then Umed took a complete charge how to drive that partner ecosystem and build it to a level where it can be called as a partner ecosystem rather than a just some kind of service providers arrangement getting aligned with the OEMs. So I think OEM word is came into existence for Frappe in recent time. There was no OEM kind of arrangement, OEM and partner arrangement initially. So that branch partner forced us to become a silver partner because we started getting a business opportunities at some good level where people started expecting us to do the implementation, not just the customization or some technical scripts writing, rather do the complete end-to-end implementations. And that was the internal peer pressure to become a silver partner and tackle that market or get into that segment where you can get into that kind of leads, that kind of business areas where you can address the solutions and start implementing the ERPs like other partner or other competitors like SAP, Oracle, or some other ERPs in the market. So in last conference, there was an aspiration we shared that we would like to become a gold partner soon. And because there was some homework going on in the back end, that luckily with Frappe, we executed enterprise implementation. And that time we got to know that there is a need of Frappe's involvement and there is a need of to become a gold partner and make our presence in a market in such a way that you have expertise, you have capabilities, you have that kind of capacities and bandwidth to execute such kind of implementations. But of course that can't be done without the help of OEM or the Frappe's involvement. So we got engaged with Frappe and executed one enterprise implementations. And that aspiration came into existence in 2023, last month itself. Now getting this tag is not a, I think, big deal. It is all about putting a upfront investment and get a tag. But what matters is about how to retain that tag. Because after a year time, if I don't generate that kind of business for me and for Frappe, then of course I need to get down to a down level, that is a silver partner again or a bronze partner. So how to retain that? So these are the couple of parameters which we have identified and which we are sharing across to our internal team all the time, and that is what we would like to share with you all guys as a partner ecosystem. So we have a team of experts which includes a combination of technical and functional expertise. Of course, there is a need of functional expertise. We can't just bang on the technical expertise. And there is a need of technical expertise too. We can't just bang on the functional expertise. Whenever we get into the ERP implementation, the customer think or check from a point of view where whether you are capable to understand the business languages and whether you map that with the product. So that is where the functional and technical expertise lies in. So how we are ensuring that? So we have made a goal for this year, for 2023, that all our team members should be certified on this platform or on this technology, that we have that kind of knowledge. We can say to a customer or to a market that we have that capabilities, we have that strength, and we have that knowledge that we can handle this framework or we can work on this framework, and we have that past experience too. So that past experience and the knowledge is going to keep us alive to retain this tag. So I think this is one of the important factors which we feel, and we got engaged with Frappe for making a certification compulsory for all our members internally. Next is a service. Next is a service quality. So service quality, of course, it like he said at the start, services, the quality aspect starts from right from the marketing. Then it gets into the how you sell, that is a pre-sales part. Then how you implement it. Then how you give a post-sales. So I am talking about the quality at the all level. So usually selling a software is quite easy. You can sell a software and get out of it by getting a license cost. But then providing a post-sales support, that is where the partner's expertise lies in. We being a partner, we have to ensure that whatever quality we are delivering in terms of implementation and even in terms of post delivery, in terms of the support, the AMC, that is where they treat us, or that is how we build a credibility over a period of time. If you are giving a good quality, even the post sales, then it becomes a benchmark, and that is how the word of mouth spreads, and you get a reference customer. And that is how I think in the last couple of years we are I would say growing, mainly because the people are referring us, because we have given a good services in spite of whether they have paid us a nominal amount or the big amount. So we are trying to maintain. So even that is one of the KRA we have shared with our team members as a part of their roles and responsibilities, where we are going to assess them while doing the appraisals or the performance check every half year or year, whether they are giving a good quality services at the implementation and even at the post-sale support. So recently we formed a team or some kind of unit. After implementation, the project should go to a hypercare team. So we have formed a hypercare team which takes care of a post-sale support. So there is a dedicated team. Earlier there were just a support engineers who were managing the support part. Now there is a dedicated hypercare team who takes care of all the implementation. Once goes live, it moves to the hypercare team, and there is a dedicated manager, dedicated engineers who takes care of the post-sales part. Of course, the third part is what, if you want to retain this tag, you need to be in sync with the thought process of a Frappe team. Because every conference, we see a different thought process, not the complete different. So it is not a 360 degree change, but yes, there is a slight enhancement, not slight, a big enhancement in their thought process. So we have to be keep aligned with their thought process, so that whatever we are saying or we are selling as a partner, that is what even they are talking about, or they are having a different thought process altogether, but we are getting into a different domain altogether or a different way of working altogether. So that needs to, that gets aligned if it if we are in sync with the CSMs, CSM is the right word, no? Customer Success Managers, or with the Frappe, the partners who are helping us to onboard the customers. So that way we can align, keep aligned with the thought process of Frappe. Next is about keeping ourselves updated about the enterprise plans. These enterprise plans change quite frequently in the last couple of year or month. So if we are keeping ourselves updated, the same pitch can be given in the form of sales pitch to a customer. We found quite difficulty in the recent time. We were talking about SMB plans. We were referring it as SMB plans. Rather, giving a information in terms of enterprise was clear, in terms of amount, in terms of offering, but we were referring it as SMB plans. So that position, how we are positioning it and what value, what name, nomenclature we are talking about, that makes a difference. So to keep that clarity and to avoid any kind of confusions to a customer in terms of understanding, it is good to align with the all the overall enterprise plans and whether we are making it as a part of your offerings as a proposals. So I remember a few incidents in recent time in the last couple of months where we offered a different cost to a customer of our enterprise plans, whereas we got, you know, some different cost from a Frappe. So there was some confusion, some hiccups happened, and then it was a learning for us, of course. And then we got to know that whenever we are going to share a proposal with customer, either in a single proposal or two different proposals, it should go in a single mail. It should be happen with a single email thread, so that customer should not get a confusion whether this lead or this opportunity is handled by this partner or might be a different partner altogether. Because all the time, most of the time, the customer deals with multiple partners and they might receive a different Frappe plans from if it is coming from them. To bring a clarity and transparency, it is good, we share both the proposals at a time on a same email thread. And of course, spreading awareness about ERP Next in market and even to our internal customers, internal team members and our customers by organizing some small meetups or small talks, webinars. So that is even we are planning in recent time. We will be organizing one conference outside India and one in Pune. So for that, I am in touch with Umer. So most probably in a couple of months, we will be having one meetup or some mini conference in Pune. That's what we are planning for. Let's see how it goes. So I think these are the parameters which help us to retain that tag. If we continue with this stuff, definitely we will continue this tag for the next year. These are the advantages of gold partner or silver partner or bronze partner to become a partner. Of course, the prime preference will be given on the listings. We don't have to spend too much of efforts in convincing customer that you are the trust needs to be built automatically. So that is already there. So you have to just say you are a certified partner and we are listed on a partner portal. So that itself says that they are trusted. They are already a certified. So we don't have to spend too much of time or in convincing them. Of course, we get a discounts on the Frappe enterprise plans, which we can share with the, which we can transfer to the customers. And it helps, of course, to retain the employees and keep a balance on the hiring resources and even to retain the existing resources. These are the few of the enterprise customers which we onboarded in the recent time in India and outside India. Couple of customers are where we are helping them to move from QuickBooks to ERP Next because there is a deadline. I think in a couple of months, I think it will be obsolete. So before that, we need to move them. Couple of them are from manufacturing. So Siddhivinayak is the case. It is a Siddhivinayak Temple Trust. It is a big trust in terms of the commerce side, finance side, I think 450 crore turnover trust. So they were looking for ERP. So how to enter that segment? Being a trust or the government, public sector kind of entity, it is without RFP, we can't enter. And there are many players who are ready to give a free ERP. So SAP is one among them who would like to give a free SAP, free license. So they offered, but we were having a good connect. So we entered there by doing an assessment study. So we took an assignment of small amount and we entered there and designed the specs, how that ERP should map their automation and how it can be helpful to them. So we prepared the assessment study and prepared a report. Now that report, whenever they are going to float a tender, so that report is going to act as a scope of work. So that activity we did. Now next stage is going to be RFP, of course. So that time we are going to provision again the ERP, but for that we have already made a specing there. So these are the stages, I think, where public sector matters a lot. So in public sector, these are the homework which we need to do. Tender management, correct.
There is a term called tender bender.
Tender bender. Correct. So that is one from the pre-call point of view. Rather, we specced it from a solutioning point of view, the tech piece point of view. So we position there as an open source ERP should be a part of it. And whatever the plus points we found in the ERP Nextdoor Frappe, that what we position there. And then again, this MFA will come into picture whenever we are going to beat them. This is a team of expertise, of course. Recently we conducted offsite. So that time Umair was a part of our offsite and literally helped us in aligning thought process. See, usually me from a business development point of view or sales point of view, usually I travel and meet the Frappe community. But there is a team who worked in the back end. So they don't have what kind of thought process we are working on. So up to some level we try to pass. But when Umair visited that offsite and he was part of us, so he shared many things what happened internally in the Frappe, how they conduct various sessions, how they conduct offsite. So that literally helped us, and we had a very open discussions in that offsite. So it literally helped us a lot. These are our four locations, and recently we opened our location in Mauritius, where we had a tie-up with an organization in Mauritius. The idea behind is, see, ERP is not a license, I mean to say the CD selling kind of a business, where you sell a CD and come out of it. Rather, here you need to show your local presence. You need to show that you are going to be there if there is going to be a problem. You need to show that business continuity will be there if you are, because we have a local presence there. So due to that, we have created this. Specifically, the Hyderabad was our strategic location, and that is working out very well. Recently, we got into Mauritius, and let's see how it works out. We are executing a couple of projects in Mauritius. So if that engagement works out very well, then we will be having a good base there. So we have a local team now in Mauritius who takes care of business development, who takes care of L1 support, who takes care of the functional part. The rest implementation and execution will be taken care of by the backend team from Pune, Mumbai. That's it.